What's up, you guys? Jeffro back again. Welcome to the Monkey Cave. So this is the tool segments. I'm sharing with you guys the tools I use to build the off-road trucks. In this episode, it's something that's kind of special to me, and that is the world of welding. If you're not already familiar with me and welding, I'll tell you a little bit about myself. I've been welding for 20 years, and I've worked in a lot of different capacities as far as welding goes. I can stick weld, I can MIG weld, I can flux core weld, I can dual shield weld, and of course, I can TIG weld. So, I've had the opportunity to work for very small job shops, doing just about anything that comes in the door. I've had the opportunity to work for water jetting facilities that build oil rig components and offshore components, things like that. And I scratched and clawed my way all the way to the top, ultimately culminating in working for one of the largest corporations on the planet in their aerospace division, specializing in aluminum and aircraft fuselage components. I've also had the opportunity to work in welding education, which was a great experience. So when I talk about welding, I like to think that I know what I'm talking about. However, I don't consider myself the best. I've been at it a long time, and sometimes I feel like I'm sliding off, especially when I was working in welding education because I didn't weld every single day. So I have some friends who they just blow me away at how good they are, including MIG welding and TIG welding. Now I specialize in TIG welding, especially aluminum. I'm pretty knowledgeable as far as that goes. My sight isn't as good as it used to be, so sometimes I've got to break out, magnifying glasses and things like that just to do the very small stainless steel components. As my YouTube grows, I will definitely get into showing you guys some of my welding techniques and things like that. I like to find them very special. However, I know there's plenty of guys on YouTube out there showing you how to weld, so that's not really something I want to focus my channel on. However, I do know what I'm talking about, so if you have questions, I would love to be able to answer them, especially if you follow me. So, let's get right into my tools, okay? First and foremost, this is my Miller 212 MIG welder. This is pretty much my workhorse in this shop. This guy gets down in boogies. It was part of a sponsorship package from a friend of mine called Full Size Invasion. You should give them a look. They do a lot of tours in Moab and things like that, 4x4 stuff. Great friend of mine. So, I also have the matching Miller 625 Extreme Plasma Cutter hooked up to my CNC table over there. I'll do a special on that later. But this machine right here, this is my workhorse, like I said. So, our show is sponsored by Blue Demon Welding Products. I've been working with them for years. Before they even sponsored me, I used their products. I have a great deal of respect for the quality that they bring for me and all of that. I have some friends who are so good at MIG welding that they will blow your mind. I'm not. I've been welding a long time, like I said, but I'm not as good as some of those guys. So I know some of their secrets and things like that, and I choose to employ mine a little bit differently. And that's kind of what the world of welding is, unless you're being held to a standard like an aerospace or any of that, where you're actually American Welding Society D17. Things like that, so, or your D1 if you're in structural, so on and so forth. So, obviously, Blue Demon Welding Products, I run their hood, all of that. This machine, I run 035 wire. Now, like I said, I have some friends who are very good. They choose to run 30,000ths wire, and what that does is it slows you down during the welding process and things like that. So when we get to me doing film specials on YouTube for welding, I kind of look forward to it. However, I know there's a lot of guys out there already teaching welding. So I would just be another face in the crowd as far as that goes, and that's okay. I've had this machine about 10 years. When I turned it on, it works, and I love that, right? Here, my Miller Sinkerwave 250. This is probably one of the most common TIG welders you're gonna find, and they are known for working. When you turn on the switch, it turns on. And if that's what happens, you're pretty happy with that, right? So like I said, I've had the opportunity to work for some big corporations and things like that. So I love TIG welding. It happens to be something very special to me. I specialize in aluminum, which a lot of people consider difficult. If I get the opportunity in some of my later episodes, I can hopefully cover some of the things that people don't realize is what makes the aluminum difficult. If you can understand the characteristics of the material, It can help alleviate some of the issues you might come into when welding on aluminum. So I'd love to show you guys that stuff a little bit later. But for now, we're just kind of covering the segments on the tools. So Sinkerwave 250, Miller 212, I keep my garage blue. On a special note, I'd like to share with you guys a little something, right? So I use a traditional dash 20 torch. I am water cooled, so this torch can run most of the day. However, there is something special that a gentleman brought to market a few years ago, and his name is Michael Furick. M. Furick on Instagram and probably Facebook too. You can look him up on Amazon. And what he did is he basically single-handedly changed our industry with this guy right here. It's a little bit more durable than your traditional pink ceramic cups. He also has a gas lens inside of these, things like that. They're so efficient and they so work so well that, like I said, I think he actually influenced our industry at pretty high levels, which is absolutely respectable. So if you're looking to get into TIG welding, I suggest looking up Michael Furick.